data communication and networks. This subject, you will see the topics: data communications, networks, network types, and internet history. So we'll discuss about internet history. So this internet history, or the history of internet, we'll discuss it in three titles: early history of internet, and birth of the internet, and internet we are using today. So in the early history, it is before 1960, that is the period of telegraph and telephony. That period is the early history period of internet. And the birth of the internet, it is during the period of 1972. They did the Interneting project, Winchef and Bobcorn. They are part of the core ARPANET, and they are doing the Interneting project. So they come up with a device called a gateway to serve, or to do service. So a device is invented, and that device is used as a gateway to serve the intermediary between the hardware to transfer data from one network to another network. And next, the internet today, which is having so many new applications. So in that way, we can discuss the history of internet. These three headings we will discuss. So first one, early history. The early history period, it is of birth of packet switch networks and ARPANET. So that is evolved in this early history period. The birth of packet switch networks, for that Leonard Clenirub in 1961 at MIT, Manchester Institute of Technology, he came up with the concept of packet switch networks. And at the same time, two other researchers, that is Paul Brand at Rand Institute and Donald Davis at National Physical Laboratory in England, they published a paper about packet switch networks. So in this way, the packet switch networks evolved the early history of internet. And during the early history, the ARPANET is also the ARPANET, the mid-1960s, only mainframe computers are used for research. And these computers, they were not communicating with one another. So what they did means, the Advanced Research Projects Agency in the Department of Defense was interested in finding a way to connect computers. So in 1969, with the Association for Computing Machinery, ACM, the ARPA presented its idea for the Advanced Research Projects Agency network, a small network of connected components. And in between that, they come up with an intermediary device called the Interface Message Processor. The Interface Message Processor, it connected to each other. So it will connect to computers, and that interface message processes also, they will connect to each other, and they can also share. So it is able to communicate in a network or in its own network. So then in 1969, ARPANET was a reality. So how they interconnected? The four nodes at the University of California at Los Angeles, and the University of California at Santa Barbara, Stanford Research Institute, and the University of Utah were connected through the internet message process to form a network. And software, it is a device, IMP is a device, so software is called the Network Control Program, provided communication between the host. So NCP is the network control program or the software to communicate between the host. So this is the packet switched network, and ARPANET is the early history of the internet. Next, these are the very important things, that is the birth of the internet. So the birth of the internet in 1972 by the Interneting Project only, they come up with a device that is a gateway to serve. So that hardware that is evolved, and in the birth of the internet, the main part is the TCP/IP. Chirp and Kahn in 1973, in their paper, they outlined the protocols to achieve the end-to-end delivery of data. So for that, the software they used as protocol software, and the device what they use means network control program, and then transmission control protocol, and then interface message processor. So they use this through three to ensure the end-to-end delivery of data. And in 1977, an internet consisting of three different networks, ARPANET, packet radio, and packet satellite, was successfully demonstrated. And in 1981, under a Defense Department contract, UC Berkeley modified the Unix operating system to include the TCP/IP. And in 1983, the authorities abolished the original ARPANET protocols, and then the TCP/IP became the official protocol for the ARPANET. So TCP/IP is about. And then is the MILNET. So MILNET in 1983, the ARPANET is split into two networks, that is military network MILNET for military users and ARPANET for non-military users. And then CSNET, that is the computer science network, 1981, a network sponsored by National Science Foundation, and it is CSNET was less expensive network, and there were no redundant links, and the transmission rate was slower. Mid-1990s, US universities with computer science departments were part of the CSNET. The term internet, originally associated with government-funded connected networks, now referred to the connected networks using TCP/IP protocols. And next one is the NSFNet. So this NSFNet, this is in the year 1986. They sponsored the National Science Foundation Network, a backbone that connected the five supercomputers. In 1990, ARPANET was officially retired and was replaced by NSFNet. And then ANSNet, 1991, IBM Meritware Research formed a protocol organized advanced network and services to build a new high-speed and internet backbone called Advanced Network Services Network. So that is ANSNet. So TCP/IP, MILNET, then CSNET, the NSFNet, and the ANSNet, these are the birth of the internet. Next, today, what about the internet? So that mainly in three categories. First thing, World Wide Web. So World Wide Web, the 1990s, the emergence of the world with the World Wide Web, WWW. The web was invented by CERN by Tim Berners-Lee, and then they added the commercial applications to the internet. And multimedia applications such as voice over IP, so that is the telephony service, and video over IP, that is the Skype service, and viewing YouTube and television over IP, that is the IP live, increases these categories, they increase the number of users of internet because of this multimedia applications, and then the peer-to-peer applications. So the peer-to-peer networking is also a new area of communication with a lot of potential. So that is it gave the way to evolution of so many applications or internetwork applications. So the history of internet is of early history, and the birth of the internet, and then internet